Hey guys, it's Keith Brown, and we're talking about Mark chapter 4, the seed, the parable of the seed and the sower, and this is Tack Room Devotional. Yesterday we talked about the fact that the seed, remember, the seed is the word. Again, a parable is a story using natural terms but trying to speak of a spiritual concept. And so, again, when Jesus is explaining this this parable, he says the seed is the word. So when the sower sows the seed, he's sowing the word. And yesterday we looked at the seed by the wayside. Today I want to pick it up with the seed on stony ground. It starts in verse 16. It says, "These likewise are the ones sown on stony ground, who when they hear the word, immediately they receive it with gladness. And they have no root in themselves, and so endure only for a time. Afterwards, when tribulation or persecution arise for the word's sake, immediately they stumble." Very interesting here, because the word is sown, and notice what it says. It says, "And immediately they receive it with gladness." Now, I can tell you as a minister, I see this all the time. People hear the word sown, they go, "Wow, that is so amazing." And they receive it because they want to. They see that it's truth, and so they receive it, but it doesn't have any root. They don't have any root. In other words, they have no foundation to their Christianity. Yeah, you can go to church all the time, but if you don't study this stuff, if you don't make it a part of your life, there's no root, there's no foundation, right? And so it says that immediately they receive it with gladness, and they have no root to themselves. Now you think about a plant that's planted. If it has no root, I mean, wind comes up or anything, this thing blows over because it has no foundation. A tree has to have a root system that holds it in place so that when the wind blows or whatever happens, you know, the snow hits or something, it has something to hold it firm in the ground. And it's the same thing with us. And that comes from our studying the Word of God, but hanging out with other Christians that speak truth, and also hanging out in the presence of God. Let me read on. And it says, "Afterwards, when tribulation or persecution arise for the word's sake." In other words, here comes tribulation or persecution in your life, and what does it come for? It comes for the word's sake. In other words, do you know enough of the word that you can stand firm and not be blown over? And notice what it says. And it says, when this persecution arises for the word's sake, immediately they stumble. Now, that word there actually means to be offended. In other words, we get offended because it just doesn't seem like the word is working. Well, you see, we need to be faithful to the word. Many times God allows us to be tested tested by the word. In other words, he tells us the word, speaks the truth. Now, can you live it? Can you apply it to your life? And the Bible says many times, it says that after we've suffered for a while, or after we've endured or persevered, then the promise comes. So sometimes what happens is we just have to prove ourselves faithful. We are men and women of faith. We believe in this and we stand on it. And many times our prayers are not answered immediately, but it takes a little bit of time. So again, don't get discouraged. Don't get down. When you find the word and what it says in the word about your situation, your circumstance, your tribulation, your persecution, whatever it is, stand firm on the word. Allow the word to be the foundation of your walk with God. And you'll find out it doesn't make any difference what kind of wind blows in your life. You're going to be strong. Again, read this over. We'll talk again tomorrow. Remember, Jesus loves you. I love you. I pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek him and serve him.